7 and 8. Let us read. And it came to pass after these things that his master's wife cast her eyes before him. And she said, lie with me. But he refused and said unto his master's wife,
behold, my master has not dwelt with me in the house, and I have committed all that he had to my hand.
Lord Jesus, bless the reading of your word. In the name of Jesus. Amen. 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 God bless you. So today, we are going to stick in the book of Genesis, studying the faith of Joseph. Amen. Amen. So we are trying to study how Joseph was in the trials. Amen. Amen. Joseph was the beloved son of Jacob. And after that, Joseph was betrayed by his brethren. They sold him to Ishmaelites, and Joseph was brought to Egypt. Amen. Amen. So you see the life of Joseph, there's ups and downs. But I was just telling you that last time. I was telling you that God was with Joseph. Amen. If you notice something there, when Joseph went down, God was there. When he was going up, God was with him. And you notice another thing, that Joseph was a kind of person who never complained about anything. Amen. Amen. When his life was flourishing, when he was going up the mountain, I mean, like when his life was flourishing, you see what I mean? You understand what I mean? When he became the boss in the house of Potiphar, Joseph didn't exalt himself. He was a humble man. When he went down to the ditch, Joseph was a humble man. He didn't complain. Amen. So what kind of faith he had, Joseph? That's exactly what we are studying. We are studying the story of Joseph, but also we are trying to see what kind of faith Joseph had. Amen. The way he was acting, the way he was trusting God, if everything was taking place, Joseph committed himself to the Lord. Amen. And Joseph came to Egypt after being sold by his brethren. He was brought to the land of Egypt, where Joseph had never been before. Amen. So even when he was taken there, Joseph didn't know where he was going. He didn't know the future. Amen. Amen. But Joseph knew only one thing, that God held the future. You understand? Yeah. He knew that God knows about the future. I may not know the future. Amen. As a child of God, I may not know the future, but God knows the future. So it's better for me as Joseph, like Joseph, to be with God, amen? To stay with God, for God knows the future. God is going to lead me. God is going to direct my path. God is going to tell me what to do and what to never do. That's the reason I'm always telling you that as believers, you must trust God. Do you understand? You must trust God. In everything you do, commit yourself to God. Amen. When something is going wrong, instead of complaining, commit yourself to God. There's no virtue, but what I'm saying, in complaining. When you're complaining, sometimes when you complain too much, people will say, oh, he's complaining too much. You understand? You are trying to explain to people, for them to understand what's taking place, what's happening to you. But when you start telling people too much, as people will say, oh, he's always complaining. Amen. You think that the person is complaining, but the person himself thinks that I'm trying to tell them to know what I feel. Do you understand? But after a moment you say, oh, come on, it's too much. It's like in somewhere in Africa. Okay? A father lost his wife, wife. And that man was crying. People came. Say, oh, sorry about that, sorry. Oh, she was my beloved wife. I loved her so much. Oh, Yeah, we know it's very hard. People come today, maybe we feel, I show you it's life, we know it's hard, we know, but try to understand, try to accept things like that. Tomorrow the people will come again. 1 year, the guy still crying. Do you know what happened? After that people said, come on, that's too much now. Yeah, it's hard, we know, but it must pass. So, nobody's going to understand, but God is kind of person, you can come to God, telling God about something, God will never get tired of you, you understand? God is always there to understand, God is always there to give answer, God is always there to keep his children. That is the reason I'm always telling you that you need to trust God, and God is the word. Everything but what I preached, trust the message, believe the message, apply the message in your life, then you see God will help you. Amen. But the Bible says that the only way for Satan to get you, the first thing Satan must do, you know what is that? Is to take you out from God. Once you are out of God, you are with Satan. Straight away, he's going to do whatever you want to do with you. Now you see here, Joseph, this fine boy, in the land of Egypt, he could say that, oh, thank God, I know that everything took place, everything was happening to me, is God was trying to take me in this place, to be the boss of this place. He could say, oh, I'm fine here. I'm able to eat. Yeah. I've got good job here in the house of Potiphar. Everything is fine. Oh, praise God. I'm okay here. Oh, God. Thank you. Amen. But in the house of the Potiphar, the Bible says, and it came to pass after these things that his master's wife cast her eyes upon Joseph. So the master of the house started thinking that he can take Joseph as boyfriend. Do you understand? And this was a big problem. Listen, you are married. Another thing is, you are the wife of my boss. So how do you expect me to become your husband, to become your boyfriend? How can you expect that? Do you understand? Joseph, the son of God, because he had the word of God in his heart, Joseph said, whatever, I'm not attending a church, whatever, I don't have any Bible with me, but the word of God is in my heart. What you're asking me to do, I'll never do it. And she said, if you don't do it, I'm going to lie to the people that you wanted to do it to me. Joseph said, you can do whatever you want to do, but me, I'll never do it. Because God is in my heart. If I do it, I'll be in condemnation with God. Amen. So people can accuse you. They can accuse you whatever they want to. But as long as you are clean in your heart, you are quiet, calm as you can be. Do you understand? So it's not what the people accusing you for, but it's what you are doing. Sometimes you can do something, no one sees you. But yourself in your heart, you know that I'm not in good relationship with God. You know that. You know how to see someone to tell you something you did. No. But what I'm saying that the heart of people are the throne of judgment. But what I'm saying that the judgment starts, begins in the house of God. And the house of God is you and me. You understand? Your heart is where God dwells. If you do something bad, the condemnation must come from your heart. And don't try to say, I don't care. If you say that, you leave sin. You go sin to sin, sin to sin, and you are lost. Once you hear that voice, that small voice in your heart, telling you that don't do it, straight away stop it. You understand? Stop it straight away. Otherwise, you go sin. David took someone's wife, and you know the story, isn't it? And then he said, oh, what I'm going to do now? So I don't want people to know about it. So I was going to send that man to the world, let him to die. And he sent that man to the world, he died. Only. You see, he went sin to sin. So when you hear that voice, stop it. But Lord was talking about the dog. He said, a man had a dog. You know the story? That man who had a dog, and he went to dig diamond. He took a big, he got a big diamond. He came to him in his house. He said, oh wow, this big diamond will give me millions of pounds. So let me keep it there. So tomorrow morning when I wake up, I'll go and sell it, get millions of pounds. Oh wow, I'm rich. And during the night, the thief was coming in the house to steal the diamond. And the dog was trying to tell his master that there's someone coming in the house. And the dog started barking. Woo! 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 And the man said, you stop it! Don't disturb me because I'm sleeping, because tomorrow morning I'll be a rich man. You stop it, okay? Because the dog can tell you things like human being, isn't it? You want to sleep again. This dog start again. Woo! 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 Say, hey! What's wrong with you? I told you that. Keep quiet! You're disturbing me because I'm sleeping. Tomorrow morning I'll be rich. Once more, if you bark again, I'm going to kill you. Okay? That's the dog. He wants to sleep again. And the dog starts barking again. Woo! Woo! Say, okay, because you don't listen to his God. Bow! The dog died. He went to bed and said, oh, finally, I'm going to sleep quietly. When he went to sleep, thief got to dinner in the house. They took diamond and they took the gun to kill the man. He went to fight. But when I said, why? He said, because he was trying to stop the dog. The dog was trying to tell him, to warn him, the danger was coming. Are you familiar? As a child of God, there's a small voice, is like that dog. When you do something bad, that small voice is always warning you, be careful, be careful. When you say, oh, leave me alone, leave me alone. Every human being has got the dialogue, has got the thoughts in the heart. Is it true? Yeah? Every human being talks to herself or to himself. Even you don't use your lips to talk, but in your heart, sometimes you are telling yourself some things. Listen, even myself, sometimes we want to do something, I say, oh, come on, you stop it. I'll tell you myself. So what do you want to do now? Do you think what you're going to do, do you have to do it? Do you think this one is not to honor God? Eric, come on, stop it. And I'll stop it. The Bible says life is a battle, everyday battle. Everyday battle. So every time before to do something, I'm always telling you that, ask yourself a question. Can God do it? Can Jesus do it? Can Balabaram do it? You want to smoke a cigarette? Ask yourself a question. Can Balabaram smoke a cigarette? If no, don't do it. You want to eat? Can Balabaram eat? Yeah, why not? Then eat it. You understand? You want to steal? Can Balabaram steal? No, stop it. You understand? You want to go for boyfriend, girlfriend, can Balabaram do it? No. Stop it. Amen. But Joseph refused and said unto his master's wife, behold, my master worketh not what is with me in the house. What's that mean? The master didn't hide anything from me. You understand? The master gave me, he told me all the secrets of the house. That means he trusted me. So why should I do such thing? Joseph said, no, I can't do it. Because don't
disappoint
someone will trust you.
It's very bad. If someone trusts you, I say, oh, brother Israel, you're my brother. So I'll give you this guitar, for example, keep it with you. I want you to practice, things like that. Do you understand? Because I trust you, I do believe that nothing bad is going to happen to the guitar, for example, and you're going to keep it. Do you understand? And when you get the guitar in the house, to your house, someone comes to you and say, oh, I want to buy this guitar. Can you sell it? No. You tell the person, no, I can't do it. It's not mine. Yeah, it's not yours, but you've got it with you. Say, yes, the person whatever gave me the guitar because it was him. He knows that I'll never do anything bad with the guitar. So I don't want to disappoint him. I don't want to betray him to say that, oh, it's not, I'm going to tell him what, like, oh, someone stole the guitar when you sold the guitar to someone else. You understand? So don't betray the trust. Joseph said, my master loves me. I came from the land of Egypt. From the land of from Israel. I came to this country as a stranger. I was a slave. But this man gave me a wonderful place. He gave me almost the top place in this house. So why should I disappoint him? Why? And apart from that, I am also a child of God. Why should I do such thing? Are you with me?
Yes.
Why should I do such thing? No, I won't do it. Amen. The faith of Joseph. If the children of God can have this kind of faith, God is going to help you. Trust in God. Trust in His word. Live a Christian life, then you will attract people to the word of God. I've got a testimony. One of the brothers told me that no one preaches me the message, but I saw the message in your life. I used to work with that man. He wasn't a message believer. We used to talk all the time. Talk. I didn't tell him anything about the message before. But the man was just watching me and another boy, another friend. He was watching us. The way, if we sit down, we only talk about the word. Never talk about people. Talk about the message, about God's, about the Bible verses, and enjoying it. He told me, he said, I never see people sitting down. Years after years I've been observing you, you're still talking only about the Lord. This one you can't find it anywhere. That means that what you're believing is the truth. I'm one of you. He became a message believer. He was baptized in the name of Lord Jesus Christ. Until now, he remained in the message. Do you understand? What you profess to be, what you believe, let people to sow it in your life, to see it in your life, sir. Amen. You see, sometimes you don't have courage to tell people about the word of God, isn't it? Sometimes you feel like it's very embarrassing. Maybe the person is going to reject it. Yeah. I want to tell them about the word of God, but maybe they are going to reject it. Maybe they're going to make it a big problem. Yeah. Sometimes this will happen. But the only way you can show, you can preach to people, is to apply the message in your life. Amen? But when I say that, have a different life, live differently from the people of the world. Have a clean life. The way you are living your life, the people will tell you that you are a child of God. I've told you my testimony where I used to work in Glasgow. White people, they told me that we've seen Christian, but you are a Christian. Do you understand? White people, they don't pray, they don't go to church, but they gave me a testimony. I've been with them almost 10 years, working together with them. They never tell me such thing.
But to the end of it, I went with a good testimony. They so Jesus in me. So if they don't believe the message, they don't believe Jesus Christ, that's their business. I've done my job. So my life was kind of judgment to them. So if they don't believe, God has got something to condemn them, to send them to hell. Amen. Because I was preaching the message in my life. My master wasn't not what is with me in the house. My master didn't hide anything from me. Why should I do this? And he had committed all that he had to my hands. Amen. Why should I do this? Joseph said, sorry, I can't do it. I'm a child of God. God is with me. Sorry. And she said, and she caught him by his garment, saying, lie with me. And he left his garment in her hand and fled and go him out. Do you understand? That woman was trying now to take Joseph by force. Joseph, I like that name. Brother Joseph, I like your name. So we are talking about you. So you must show us that you are Joseph. Do you understand? Because Joseph, the name is also the nature. You must have the nature of Joseph. Show to the people that you are Joseph. Yeah? So, that woman decided now to take Joseph by force. What Joseph did, Joseph was trying to fly away from her. And she took Joseph. She took Joseph like this. And Joseph left his garment in that woman's hand. Because that woman was trying to destroy Joseph's life. Do you understand? Joseph knew that if I do this, first of all, my master will get me out. He can even kill me. Because that Potiphar was the second personality in Egypt. He had power to kill people. Jesus said, I can't do it. Anyway, I'm a child of God, I can't do it. If Potiphar put Joseph in his house because he trusted Joseph, do you understand? Joseph said, I can't do it. Sorry. Joseph, you want to come here? Say, no, I can't do it. And took Joseph by his garment, and Joseph running away, the garment left in that woman's hand. Amen?
Amen.
And it came to pass when she saw that he had left his garment in her hand and was fled forth, that she called unto men of her house and spake unto them, saying, see, he hath brought in an evil unto us to mock us. He came in unto me to lie with me, and I cried with a loud voice. She's telling me lie. You understand? That's exactly what she wanted to do. And she's trying to say that Joseph wanted to do it to her. They took Joseph to the prison for the lie. So Joseph came to say, Father, what's happened to me? You gave me a big job, a good job, but now I'm getting in trouble again. So tell me what I must do now. Yeah. Amen. Amen. The life of Joseph. But Joseph never complained. But this one was the way for God to take Joseph to the place he wanted him to be. God has a plan with Joseph. Amen? Joseph himself, he didn't know anything about it. That's the reason as a child of God, you must commit yourself to God. God has got a plan for everyone. Do you understand?
Yes.
God has got a plan for everyone. So you don't know, but God knows why you are here. Because God said that they are going to get out from that land. He said, you get in. He said also, you get out. Do you understand?
Through Joseph, they got in. Through Moses, they got out. You understand? God works only with one man. To get them in, it was with Joseph. To get them out, it was with Moses. Amen. To fall in sin, it was just with one man. Who was it? Adam. To get out of the sin, only one man. Who was it? Jesus. You understand? That's the way God works. God doesn't work with groups. It takes only one man, you understand, to do what he wants to do. He said, my people will get in slavery for 400 years. How? God didn't say that everybody will go to the slavery together. It took just one man, Joseph, took him there. You understand? Joseph now went to the prison because that woman accused him to be a bad boy, for doing bad things when it was a lie. Joseph said, right, he went to the prison, He didn't complain. And when he went to the prison, he started doing things in a good way. Even the boss of the prison was watching Joseph and said, hey, what kind of boy is this one? This boy is in the prison, he's not complaining. He's always happy. In the prison. Can you imagine Joseph came from the top place, the second boss in the life of in the house of Potiphar. He came down. Joseph lost the job to begin with. Yeah. Secondly, Joseph lost money. And Joseph lost his reputation. All the land, they knew that Joseph was a bad boy. Because Joseph didn't explain it. But in his heart, he knew that he was a good boy. I don't care what the people tell about me. I do care what God says about me. That's a good testimony. Amen. Amen. Sometimes people can say, oh, you're a good boy, oh, that boy is a very good boy. But in your heart, you know that you are not good with God. You can be good with all of other people, but if you are bad with God, you're still bad. Amen. Amen. Be good with God first. Have a close relationship with God first. Amen. Not with the people. Let people reject you for God, but don't let God reject you for people. I don't care what people can say about me. But I even so, but I even believe this, I don't care. As long as what I'm saying, I say amen. If you love me because of what I believe, God bless you. If you don't love me, that's your business. As long as I'm sincere with God, I stay with him. Always say, telling people, in my family, I'm the only person believer. They don't believe what I'm in my family. I say, that's your business. Me, I believe what I'm. Every time when I go there, I say, oh, you always report. I say, listen, you are my family. But if you want to keep a good relationship with me, please don't touch me anymore. Leave me alone. I understand if you don't believe in his message. That's your business. That's your opinion. I respect that. But don't try to say bad things against my brother. Otherwise, you can be my uncle. You can be my cousin, my brother, my sister. I'll cut you out of my house. Yeah, straight away. The message comes first. I told my mom the message comes first. I'm able to go out from the family. Do you understand? But I'll never let this message down. Amen. Because if today my life ends, no one is gonna save me. No one is gonna go with me. But I want to say that there's not enough place for everyone. There's only a place for you and Jesus. You understand? So Jesus comes first. Joseph had a bad reputation. All the men of Egypt, they said, Joseph is a bad boy. See what you wanted to do. Why? That woman could go to the court, tribunals, and prove that Joseph is a bad boy. How? See? This is government. Amen. What is this? He's government. He's a bad boy. I told you. You always say he's a good boy. He's not. He's a bad boy. You want to do this and that to me. See, his government is here. He's a bad boy. Joseph could explain. Who's going to believe him? No one. He went quietly in the prison. He was sitting in the prison knowing that he was innocent. Amen. But the main thing was that Joseph was with God. God was with Joseph directing his path. He knew that as long as God is with me, I'm fine. Amen. All the land of Egypt can call me a bad boy, but as long as God says that I'm a good boy, I'm still a good boy. Amen. All the people in the world can say that I'm a bad boy or I'm a good boy. As long as God says you're bad, you're bad. Amen. So it's not about what the world says, but it's about what God says. That's the faith of Joseph. Trust in God in everything. I'll never do anything as long as God doesn't tell me to do it. I have to follow God. Sorry, I can't do it. I'm a child of God. Okay, if you don't do it, I'll tell people you are a bad boy. I'll tell people you've done this and that to me. You make a choice. He said, go and tell people. I'm not going to do it. But the Bible said that even Potiphar knew that Joseph was right. Because he trusted him. He knew Joseph. Said, this boy will never do such thing. But that's what was the way God was using to take him. Take him up. Do you understand? Sometimes you get in trouble, you are complaining for nothing. It's the way God uses to take you up. Amen. But when I say that, the way up is down. You see, you know, in the pyramids, it was like this. Okay? In Egypt, okay? Do you know the way to get in the pyramid? People was there looking how to get inside of the pyramid. They didn't know. To get in the pyramid, there was a way like this. From there. And then from there underground, then you get inside. So to get in the pyramid, it was here. So you must go down and then go up. And when they took those people studying pyramids, they said, we are trying to get inside our pyramid, but we can't get there. How do you manage to get there? They said, oh, where did you go? They said, we've been around here, all over around the pyramid, trying to see the entrance. You didn't see anything. He said, no, the entrance is over there. It's not even there. You understand? Because this place here was far from the pyramid. Where? Said, over there. Said, no. We are trying to get inside here. Why are you sending us over there? Said, yeah. They said, we've been there, but we saw that it was going down. He said, yes, of course. You must go down and then you go up. You understand? The way up is down. If you humble yourself, God will raise you up. If you're trying to make yourself big, God will make you small. Yeah. You are trying to make yourself a cow, God will make you a frog. Do you understand? Make yourself small and God will raise you up. Joseph was down in the prison. If you notice something, every time when Joseph was going down, after that he was going up. Listen. From the pit, he went down. He was taken to the house of Potiphar, went up. Amen. Amen. To go up again, he was taken down in the prison. When he got out from the prison, he went up. Because in the prison, he met two people. Who was it? The butler and the baker. So tell me, how Joseph is going to meet those people if he didn't go to the prison? He had to go to the prison to meet these people. And God desired this one for more, for Joseph to meet those two people. When Joseph went to the prison, those two people made the mistake, and the king was angry to them. He said, I'm going to send you to prison. They were taken to prison because God has a plan. Amen. God has a plan. Every child of God, you must know that God has got a plan for you. Taken to the prison, and God to the other side, he was preparing also the butler and the baker to meet Joseph over there. And at the same time, God was making it as a type of Jesus Christ on the cross. Amen. So, try to walk in all the ways to bring things together. Are you with me? It was for Joseph, but also it was for Jesus. To give the type of Jesus. And Bible said that if we follow the type of Joseph, we're going to understand much easier who Jesus Christ is. You understand? We are going to understand where we are standing now in the dispensation. You understand? That's the reason I'm taking you to this story of Joseph. And you are going to see to the end of it, when Joseph was meeting his brethren. Bible said that Joseph was meeting his brethren. His brethren came from the land of Israel to the land of Egypt. And his brethren, they are Israel people. They had to come here. The Egypt was showing the nation out of Egypt is what we call Gentiles. Do you understand? So they had to come to the land of the Gentiles to meet Joseph. Because Joseph didn't go back to Israel. He stayed in Israel, in Egypt. Those people, those Israelites, must come to meet Joseph in Egypt. Do you understand? God was showing those people of Israel will get enslaved. He went in the prison, meeting the butler and the baker. And Joseph had those two people, but the butler and the baker had dreams. Joseph was there to explain the dream. You tell me a dream. I had such a dream. Next time we study those dreams. One dream was telling that God is going to destroy, the king is going to restore you to your place. To the other one, he said that you get out of the prison, but he killed you. And that person was angry to Joseph. Joseph said, listen, I'm not trying to make it up. It's not me. I'm trying to explain to you your dream. It's what God told me to do. It's not about me. He was angry to Joseph. And the Bible says that it happened exactly in the way Joseph said. He was taken, was killed, and another one was taken back to the house of Pharaoh, the king. And when Pharaoh had the dream, he said, oh king, I know someone in the prison. That person is able to explain the dream. So, go and take it. They went to God, Joseph. Joseph came out. Instead of going to the house of Potiphar, he went to the house of the king. Amen. So from Potiphar, he went up again. Do you understand? In the house of Potiphar, he went down to the prison. First of all, from the pit. Okay? He went down to go to the house of Potiphar. From the house of Potiphar, he went down again to go now to the house of the king. You understand? Because in God's mind, Joseph had to meet those people in the prison. Because how he's going to meet them in the house of the king is not possible. Because Joseph wasn't going there. It wasn't given to everybody to get there in the house of the king. Can you go to the house of the queen without invitation? Can you? No. But if God wants to take you there, he's gonna make his way to take you there. So Joseph from the house of Potiphar, he was taken to the prison down. and then was taken up. It was the first time Joseph meeting the king
face to face.
Can you imagine someone, the queen sent someone to take you to go and see the queen. So Joseph was standing there face to face with the king. He said, oh king, here I am, what do you want me to do? He said, oh Joseph, I've been told that you are good by interpreting dreams. Can you please tell me the dream I had, what that means? Joseph said, let me pray to my God to see if he's going to show me. And you know the dream. When Joseph told the dream, and the king said, you are the best person to take care of the land. Because you know, no one gave me the explanation to my dreams, but you did. That means that you can do better than anyone. So me, Pharaoh, I'm not going to do anything. I just give all the responsibility to it. Amen? So from the responsibility in the house of Potiphar, now he's got the responsibility in the land of Egypt. Became the second personality of the land. Why? Because God was with him. God was trying to direct his life. That's the reason Joseph never complained. His faith to God was keeping him in good mood. In the prison, if you see that, in the prison, they said that this man is good. They gave him the responsibility in prison to take care of the prison. Even the prison prospered. The prison improved. How can you improve the prison? I can't understand that. A child of God, wherever we put him, is going to prosper. He's going to improve. You understand? Because it's not him, but it's God in him. But Balaam said that when Egypt rejected Moses, they rejected God. In no age, in any age, people don't want to reject God. Israel, they didn't want to reject Jehovah. They rejected Moses. Not knowing that by rejecting Moses, they are rejecting Jehovah. Amen? And today, the human being will say that we reject William Branham, we don't reject God. Amen? But when you reject William Branham, you reject God himself. I don't want to listen to my parents. You know, you reject your parents, straight away you reject God. God will never listen to you if you don't listen to your parents. God will send you back and say, no, go and to your parents. Because the Bible says that, honor your father and mother for you to live longer. Amen. A child of God, respect parents. A child of God, hear what parents say. Amen. Schools must not have more influence in you more than your parents. Teachers in schools, they don't love you more than your parents. Your parents love you more than your teachers. You understand? Bad things have been taught in the schools, but you must be very careful. Keep the word of God in your heart and always compare. You understand? If it's contrary to the word of God, put it aside and keep going. Amen. God bless you. Amen. Any questions? Any questions? Any questions? No. Yes, it's a baby.
What happened to her?
Nothing. After that, Joseph came back, came out of the prison. Nothing happened to her. But God, maybe God did something against her. But nothing happened to her. Yeah. And people discovered after that that she was a liar. God always defends his people. Let people say bad things against you, but one day people find out that you are right.
So when you're trying to defend yourself, explaining too much, and people say, oh, keep complaining, come on. As I said, you are trying to explain yourself to the people, but people will tell you that you are complaining too much, stop it. Because it's really too much. You understand? The reason why you're explaining is because you want people to understand what took place. But the people won't understand that. You say that you're complaining too much. That means that you must commit yourself to God for everything. Yes, sir.
What did they kill?
He was killed because it was a decision of the king, because they've done something bad. And they came to find out that the butler or the baker. Who was killed?
The baker
was killed. Yeah. The baker was killed because, thank you very much, as you were reading the Bible. So the baker was killed because he did something bad and the king didn't like it. And they found out that the butler was innocent, so they took the butler back to his place. Thank you, Sister Mary, for the question. Any more question? No. Thank you. God bless you. So I want you to give me a song. What do you want to sing? You choose the song. It's your Sunday school. Who's going to choose the song? Sister Becky? Choose a song. Oh Lord, my God, have you talked about it?